This video is sponsored by Desenio.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Alexandra and you are watching Studio Fix, the series where I tackle teeny tiny apartments under 500 square feet and show you how to make them beautiful, stylish, and organized.
You got a makeover to do, so. Carla, are you ready? So if you follow me on Instagram, you probably know that we often do call outs for makeovers around Toronto. I get tons of emails and DMs from you guys asking me if I can make over your spaces. So make sure you're following me on Instagram at Alexandra Gater. All of our makeover call outs are on Instagram exclusively. So a few months ago, we put out a call out asking someone to nominate a friend, a family member that they thought deserved a complete studio transformation. And there were a lot of submissions, but we picked sisters Marguerite and Jubilee. Their story is just so special. Also, you guys, I say Marguerite's name like 18 different ways in this video before someone actually corrected me. It's Marguerite, not Marjorie. So Marguerite, I know you're watching this. I'm really sorry I got your name wrong earlier on in the video. Let's let Jubilee take it away.
Hello, Team AG. My name is Jubilee and I nominated my sister Marguerite for your studio makeover. Marguerite is the best. She's an absolute saint. She's a behavioral therapist and teaches children with autism. And although she's incredibly passionate and dedicated, her job can be quite taxing, especially with the added complications of the pandemic. She's been working from home and spends a lot of time in her apartment. Her space has so much potential, but she is in need of some serious help. We've been fans of Alexandra and the show for a while now, and I would absolutely love to completely blindside her.
Today's the day. Never done before in Team AG history. We are going to show up at someone's door, someone being Marguerite, and we are gonna surprise her with, you know, the announcement that we're gonna make over her studio apartment. Her sister Jubilee, who nominated her, as you guys saw, is gonna be there. She's expecting us, but her sister isn't. So Amanda's coming. She's gonna be our videographer today. Alana's coming to actually do the scout, and also we're gonna take you behind the scenes of how we would normally do a scout, because I know you guys all want to see the rest of the team. Alessandra's there. What are you doing?
I'm making lunch.
My sister is here in the office today, which is really fun. And okay, bye. You guys ready to go do a surprise scout? I'm actually really nervous. All of a sudden. Yeah, it's gonna be fun.
That was a cute dance.
Okay, so update. Marguerite actually isn't at home. She's at work, which is great for us because we can scout the space, take measurements without her knowing. But I think that we should FaceTime her when we're in her apartment with her sister and be like, hey, I'm in your apartment, we're making it over. So I actually think it's all gonna work out.
We used to live together, so it was like hard to part.
Yeah, I bet.
We found this place together.
This is so cute.
So it doubles as like a living area, her office, her bedroom.
The cool thing is she actually has a kitchen, which is cool.
I think it's called a junior one bedroom.
A junior one bedroom. It's a studio apartment.
And then the washroom is here.
Cool.
This was like the almost the deal breaker that there's no, you can't stand up in the shower.
Which is like a Toronto, like you're always compensating like with something in front of
you. Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
This is so cool. I'm so excited about this. Like this,
yeah, we've never done a studio like this.
Okay, so we made it to Marguerite's. Jubilee is here. We are gonna sit down with her and call Marguerite so Jubilee can reveal the surprise. In the commotion of excitement, we didn't record the FaceTime properly. So that's why you're not seeing Marguerite's face. Mercury was in retrograde. We were excited. What can I say? Technology was not on our side.
Hey, Marg.
Are you okay? What's going on?
I'm at your apartment.
You're at my apartment.
And I'm here with...
Hi!
I'm here with a whole team of people.
By now you know that your sister has nominated you for a makeover, and I'm so excited to tell you
that we are gifting you an entire studio apartment makeover. Your sister wrote like the nicest letter about you and how much you give back to the community. And I'm like getting all teary-eyed because this is why I do what I do. And I'm just so excited for you to have the space of your dreams.
Oh my gosh, I'm so speechless. I'm shaking.
It's a beautiful apartment. It's really beautiful. We're gonna get inspo photos from you and come up with a whole plan. You just like get to come home one day and your space will just be completely made over.
Oh my gosh, that's wild. Thank you so much. That is so incredible.
That was the best surprise ever. And it's time for Alana and I to get designing. So we're gonna go back to the studio and set up a call with Marguerite later on in the week just to actually talk through what she needs in this space, what she's looking for, because this is her space after all and it needs to be functional and to her taste.
So nice to see you.
Yeah, nice to see you.
We already have a general plan in our minds of what we wanna do, but there's a few things we wanted to ask you.
Okay.
Which is what we ask everyone before a makeover. Specifically, what you love about your space and what's not working. Like, what would be your dream kind of makeover?
I love that my apartment is really unique. Mm-hmm. And I also really love living in a studio. I feel like this is an appropriate amount of space for one person and a cat. As creaky as the floors are, I really love the old wood floors. I try to pick things that are unique. And then in terms of things that aren't working, I would love a little bit of like differentiation in space. My living space, I don't really use. I don't really find it that cozy. And I would love to, at the end of a really long day, move to that space and be able to put my feet up.
We noticed you had this awesome little pull down cubby desk situation.
Yeah.
Why are you not using that as your office space?
When I moved in, I was not working from home and I was going to make that a little bar, and then I don't actually drink that much, so I didn't.
We opened it and I'm like, I've never seen a cool piece like this built into a wall in an apartment.
Yeah.
I just think you'd get more space. And when you walk into your apartment, it's so beautiful, but then it's like your desk is, like you're probably constantly thinking about work.
I am.
I would suspect that. Do you think we can give you a little like weekend assignment? Can you set up your workspace in that hutch?
Okay.
It clicks, right? So like it does stay.
There's like a metal chain.
Okay.
But the chain's not connected to anything. Like I just have the chain.
I'm just worried that it's not gonna be enough space for you or comfortable enough. So you let us know and report back.
Okay.
And then we'll figure out a solution. Just let us know.
Wonderful, okay.
So here's what we learned on that call with Marguerite. She doesn't need to keep the desk and the desk chair. She'll be moving back into her office soon. And I'm happy to report that after our call, she went back, tried it out for the weekend and was like, I don't know why I didn't think of this sooner. I love it. I can totally sell this desk and this chair. Let's do this hutch work from home system. Yes.
What was that?
We also learned that Marguerite has changed around the layout of this place a ton. She told us that any configuration she's put her furniture in has worked, so the configuration of her space is really up to us. We also know that Marguerite needs a better place to sleep with side tables. Right now, she doesn't have a spot for her phone or a light. We also know that she needs a better lounge space. She wants to have people over. She wants to entertain and be comfortable, and this setup just isn't doing it for her at this time. These are the inspo photos we are working with. You'll see that she loves neutrals, soft, dusty colors, lots of whites, lots of creams, just kind of simple, but lots of texture thrown into the mix, which you guys know is my specialty.
Okay, so it is the pre-prep day for Marguerite's makeover. I am stuck at the office. We are filming a spring refresh of the office video, so I'm finishing that up. I have to hang an art print and do some painting and stuff, but Alana and Graham have saved the day. They're heading to Marguerite's and they're gonna start prepping for the makeover tomorrow. They're gonna start unpacking things, painting. You guys excited?
So excited.
Very excited.
You're like, yeah, I'm thrilled.
First thing they're doing is unboxing the sofa and bringing it up to Marguerite's.
Oh my God, this is gonna be so fun. Okay, wait, my leg is stuck.
Oh, yeah. Is it still stuck? Okay, I keep pushing it.
Every time I have to lift my hubby, I go into like hysterics. Oh my God, no, I can't.
Don't make me laugh. I'm gonna like drop this whole thing on you.
Why am I laughing so hard? No!
if you guys are wondering why it seems like Alana and Graham have taken the sofa up like 18 flights of stairs, it's because they have.
No other couch I don't think would have fit. No, like this is as big as it possibly could be. Yes.
Woo! Nice work, guys.
Round of applause, you guys. Woo!
Good job, Graham.
Thank you.
We did it.
I didn't do anything. Emotional support.
Emotional support.
We are painting the walls. My favorite pink color, Modern Love by Backdrop Modern Paint. Even though it's super subtle, it's gonna just be like a nice contrast and kind of visually divide this space so you know that like this is the little bedroom nook. We are on prep day number 2, and Marguerite has sold all of her furniture. We actually weren't expecting that, but it's great because it really gives us a blank canvas to work with. Marguerite's ready for a makeover, and I love that energy.
I'm finally here. Graham and Alana have gotten so much done, but it's nice to be here and like get started on the makeover. Alana is currently spotlighting me. It's rainy here in Toronto today. It's so dark and there's not a ton of light in this space, which we are going to fix, but just bear with me for now. Okay, so the first thing we are gonna do is start unpacking some beautiful art we received from Desenio. Marguerite doesn't have any art in her space, so we are gonna bring in some color, some pattern, these beautiful prints, and yeah, I can't wait to like unbox them and see them in real life.
Desenio is a retail company that sells high quality Scandinavian inspired prints. Their philosophy is that stylish wall art should be accessible to everyone, and that is so in line with my brand. I feel like everyone should have a beautiful space regardless of their budget. They also sell frames, picture clips, picture ledges, poster hangers, really your one-stop shop for all things wall art. Desenio is always updating their collections, so you'll always find fresh and beautiful new art prints to spruce up your home, regardless of your style. They ship worldwide, including the US, and shipping typically takes 4 to 7 business days. A huge bonus is that Desenio is FSC certified and they harvest and produce their products ethically. If you want new art to style your space, make sure you use my discount code Alexandra Gater for 40% off your purchase. All the info will be in the description box below.
We are now going to bring some light into this space because as you guys can probably tell, we're shooting in the dark. Kind of. Marguerite has a spot for a pendant light, but she hasn't added one. We found the most beautiful pendant light probably ever. That's a bold statement, but it's just so good in this space.
Okay, so because this light is so big, we're gonna have to put it as close to the ceiling as possible. Yeah, there's perfect. She has room to walk underneath.
This pendant is from Lights and Lamps. I need like 18 of these in my home. So beautiful.
You guys, it looks like a flower.
And even though it's quite large in this small space, it really is gonna act as like a statement piece that kind of anchors this whole room together.
We're also replacing this wall sconce for something a little more stylish.
This beautiful wall sconce is from a Canadian company called Huey Light Shop. I've had my eye on their lights for so long, and everything is also handmade, which is amazing.
Oh. Yay! That also gives her so much more light.
Yeah.
Now it's time to make a DIY headboard. So on this back wall behind Marguerite's bed, I knew that I wanted to have some sort of statement that went beyond just paint. So we are making a cane webbing headboard completely from scratch. The first thing we're doing is tossing the cane webbing into her bathtub.
This always feels so weird. It feels like I'm doing something I'm not supposed to be doing, but I promise you guys, this is a step you don't want to miss.
You want to make sure your cane has soaked for at least 30 minutes so it's nice and stretchy when you staple it down onto your headboard.
You can already feel how much softer it is just by being in here for 5 seconds.
Graham pre-made this frame. The wood cost him under $35. Really easy to make, just like a picture frame. And this is what we're gonna staple the cane onto.
We're gonna leave the wood just as it is so it looks like natural and it goes well with the cane. I've taken the cane over the bathtub. It's just drying a little bit.
To fasten the frame together, we're using L brackets on each side. Next, we're staple gunning the cane webbing to the frame. You wanna use lots of staples, and this is definitely a 2 to 3 person job because you wanna be stretching the cane as you staple so that when it dries, it's really nice and tight in your frame.
Just Whoa. Whoa.
It's so beautiful. Oh my gosh.
Now that we've stapled the whole thing together, it's time to hang it on the wall. To do this, we're using simple D-rings and screws in the wall. So this whole frame is going to hang just as a picture frame would on your wall. The best thing about this is that it looks custom, but Marguerite can take this apartment to apartment.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that looks amazing.
Makes like the beds seem like a king-size bed, even though it's a double.
To turn this hutch into a desk, we are using chain on either side of the desk to hold it in place. We're using two lengths of chain for each side.
Looks like you're doing a ribbon cutting ceremony.
Each chain holds 30 pounds. So this desk can basically hold over 100 pounds, which is great.
We have a desk that closes and opens.
Because this hutch had like little dips in it, we wanted to make it a super flush workspace. So we are just using particle board. And I'm painting it white. And just like that, we've turned this little hutch into the perfect work from home space. Now onto the mirror DIY. I'm so excited about this because we are going to turn one of those closet mirrors into a giant floor mirror that is an Anthropologie dupe. I think these mirrors go for like over $1,000. This mirror was something Marguerite already had. We're just upcycling it. And we wanted to shout out with Wendy because she did this on Instagram. And when we saw it, we were like, we have to recreate this. All you'll need for this DIY is a closet mirror or any kind of rectangular mirror. Though, hot tip, you can find tons of these mirrors on Facebook Marketplace or Kijiji for under $50. So to get a massive mirror that's like basically floor to ceiling for under $50 is incredible. You also need these wood ornate pieces. We got these from the craft store under $35. And you wanna pick a spray paint. We're going for a more matte gold, not like a shiny gold. And we'll show you why later on in this DIY. The first thing I'm doing is just spray painting these ornate details and I'm leaving them out on the porch to dry. The next thing we're doing is putting painter's tape all along the edges of the mirror to protect it because we are gonna spray paint the frame gold. I'm also using butcher's paper to really just make sure that no paint gets on the mirror. Now we're just spray painting the frame of the mirror. It looks so good. You just wanna do a couple coats, nothing crazy, and make sure you're doing like long strokes that are kind of farther away. That's the key to spray painting. You don't wanna like go in and just like spray paint it in one spot or it'll drip everywhere. So just like nice, long, even strokes. We're gonna let this mirror dry and finish it off tomorrow. It is day two, reveal day. Super exciting. There is a massive snowstorm outside. Yesterday it was gray and rainy. I don't know why I'm telling you this other than like, I feel like you just need to know. We are gonna start off with this mirror DIY. So as you guys saw last night, we spray painted it. We moved it in here and I'm gonna take off all the tape, all the paper, and then we are going to make it ornate. These are the spray painted pieces that I did yesterday. They're literally just like wood pieces from the craft store. We are gonna use construction adhesive to adhere them to the mirror and then clamps to hold it all in place while it dries. You guys are not ready to see this headboard. I'm just attaching it to the wall with that D-ring we installed. It's like a picture frame. It's like hanging a picture frame on a wall. Okay, it is secured. This is wild. This is such a beautiful headboard. The fact that we custom made this to fit this space is just the best. And it looks like it was always here. I love it. Okay, let's put a cute little duvet on it. Okay, now's the fun part. We're gonna peel off this tape from when Graham painted this wall. Also, I am loving the color in this little nook. It's subtle, but you can still tell that there's a pop of color. It's like calm and serene. That's how I'm feeling right now. Give this video a thumbs up if you'd like to see more ASMR breaks. So I'm using a couple of command strips to hang this beautiful Desenio print. Cute. This side table is so quirky and it just makes this bedroom come to life. And I feel like because we're keeping this somewhat neutral, having an accent piece like this is just so great. I'm gonna finish this space off. And oh my gosh, this lamp. Look at the cutest lamp you've ever seen. This little lamp, side table, the cane, the pillows, the duvet. It's a moment. To finish this little nook off, I'm hanging up Marguerite's plants that she had here before. We're just using command hooks. Elena putting the tools in her tool belt is like a mood. These plants just like totally finish this little space off. So now we're gonna move on to hanging the curtains. I don't know why I'm doing this, like jazz hands, like the curtains. Let's do it. The color of these goes perfectly with the palette we're working with. And also these little tufts are in the same shapes as on the windows. It's like we're good at our jobs or something here at Team AG. We found this tufted bench at HomeSense, and as soon as Alana sent me a picture of it, I'm like, we need to have this in Marguerite's space. It's boucle, it's an arch shape, and it was $200. A bench like this would usually cost upwards of like five. So I think this was a great deal. Not only does this bench look super cute, but Marguerite can pull this up into her living area, which we're going to tackle next when she has people over for extra seating in a studio apartment. Any kind of like decorative functional pieces you can add is ideal. So we literally turned this storage hutch into a desk. I'm so excited about it. Are you guys ready to see? Oh. The reason I'm so excited about this is because this piece was here and it just wasn't being used to its full potential. And I always say this in Studio Fix, but when you move into a tiny space, you need to like think outside the box. And turning this storage unit into a literal office is gonna be such a game changer for this space. The coolest thing is she can push everything back into here, fold the desk up, and no one's gonna know that she works from home. And she doesn't have to be staring at her work all day long, which is so great. We got her this chair from Beauclair. It's a desk chair. Not only is it so comfortable, but my idea was she could use it for even more extra seating. Let me show you. It's obviously gonna go here when she's working, okay? And then at the end of the day, when she's done working, she can just turn the chair. Carla's like, I know, it's great, right?
It looks really cool.
When Marguerite has people over, it's an extra seat along with the bench. So she has like ample seating. She can work here, sleep here, and entertain. It's incredible. Okay, now that we've done this little desk area, we're gonna move on to the living room, and I'm so excited about the living area. You guys are not ready. You're not ready for this. We are putting this rug down. This is from a company called Benny Souk, and we just thought the colorway of this rug was so perfect for this space. We've got the peach, we've got the white, the lines. This is wool. It's a really great quality rug, and it's gonna warm up the space a lot. The size of your rug is really important, especially in a small space. Always go bigger than you think you'll need. If you get a smaller rug, it's just gonna make the whole studio apartment feel much smaller than it actually is. I love this sofa, not only because it just works perfectly with all the tufts in the bedspread, the curtains, just like the whole vibe of this apartment, but also because it is perfect for a small space. That's why I love article furniture, because you can find stylish pieces that work so well in tiny studio apartments. It's wild to me that we are able to fit a sofa in this tiny space. It doesn't feel cramped, like it feels like just the right amount of space. So next, I am going to add two chairs that we thrifted. A couple days ago, Alana and Graham added these new legs onto these thrifted chairs. I found these browsing on Facebook Marketplace on a Sunday afternoon. They were $200 for the pair, which is a steal for two bucket chairs. I couldn't believe how well they matched with the rug. And these chairs paired with that pendant light are really the hero pieces of this room. See how this creates a divide between the bedroom and the office area? It's like this is the living room. It's cozy, but it doesn't feel too cramped. I also wanted to add that Marguerite doesn't have a television, but I've given her the idea. I really hope she does it after we leave this space. I think she should add a projector above the closet area so that she can just pull the projector down and watch television on her little sofa. And then when it's not in use and when she needs access to her closet, she just pulls the projector screen back up. I'm placing this coffee table from Casa Chic. You guys know I call out Casa Chic all the time. If you're looking for cool boho furniture, make sure you check her out. I will link all of these products down below. Also, I love how this coffee table is small, but still roomy. So it like fits perfectly in this tiny lounge area. I can't wait to bring this mirror in here. One, because it was just such an affordable DIY and such a fun Anthropologie dupe, but also because the key in a small space is to add mirrors. You wanna reflect the light. It's gonna make this space feel 10 times bigger than it is. Let's bring it in. Oh my God, this already looks amazing. And there's like green tape all over it. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is absolutely beyond stunning. This mirror would cost like over $1,000, hands down. This cost us like under $40, under $50. It just makes this living area look huge. Open and airy and wow. To finish this mirror off, I am gonna use some Rub and Buff. It goes on like a wax and it's much more pigmented than spray paint. So I'm using kind of like a brighter gold. This is gonna make it look like actual metal, like old antique metal. Don't mind my coffee cup. I'm using a paintbrush and I'm just like dabbing it on the ornate accents we added. You just wanna add it into like all the little grooves. I'm just adding the Rub and Buff here. And then I'm taking a cloth and just kind of wiping it all over the frame, and it just gives it this like antique finish. Now it's time for those finishing touches. We're hanging that Desenio art. It looks so good on the wall. Placing candles, books, throw blankets, pillows, just all of those things that really make a space come to life. I have like butterflies. Doing these spaces for someone who really deserves it is so meaningful, and I'm just so proud of our team for pulling this off. It looks incredible. Is it okay that I toot my own horn? It looks amazing, objectively. Biasedly, it looks great. Okay, time to reveal it to Marguerite and Jubilee. Are you guys ready? I want you to picture what your space looked like before. Can you walk me through it?
I had the bed shoved in the corner. Not very much color.
Yeah.
A little bit boring.
Yeah.
Okay, are you ready? On the count of three. One, two, three.
Oh my God.
I'm completely speechless.
Oh my God.
This is absolutely unbelievable. Oh my gosh, the headboard.
Oh, wow. Look at the little lamp. It's a baby lamp.
Oh my gosh, it's adorable.
This looks insane. Like,
it looks incredible.
You can put all of your storage, like all of your office storage away, close it up when you're done for the day, and then just pivot the chair into the corner.
I can finish my day and fully put my work away.
Exactly, instead of staring at it.
This is absolutely unreal. I have no words.
We've all said many times today, we want to move into your space, so. It's a testament to a good makeover, I think.
Yeah.
Can I give you a hug?
Thank you so much. This is absolutely unreal.
I'm so glad you like it. If you guys want to buy some Desenio art prints for your space, make sure you use my discount code. All the info will be linked in the description box below. And as always, I will see you guys next week. Bye. I'm good. Sorry. I feel like one of those cars that's like, it starts and then it like stops, you know? Like it's like breaking down and then it like, it's like, whoa, and then it like stops.